My buddy Randy Montana told me one time, you know, the music business either chooses you or you choose the business. My name's Thomas Rhett Akins, Jr. I was born in South Georgia in a town called Valdosta.
We ain't kicking it inside, but we ain't kicking it outside.
I started playing drums. My dad bought me a Pearl Rockstar kit. It was a pretty crappy kit, but, you know, we made it work.
Here comes the double kit, everyone. Ben, you ready?
Ready.
Am I getting better?
It wasn't until probably 10th or 11th grade where I actually picked up an acoustic guitar and let him teach me a few chords.
The other night, me and my friend were at the bar, and these five little cute girls sitting over in the corner, and they kept whispering, looking at me, and I was like, they're probably going to come over here and want to take a picture or something here in a minute, so. They kept whispering and pointing. And they finally walked up to us, and they said, can we ask you a question? I said, yes, ma'am. She goes, are you Red Akins? And I said, yeah. They went, oh, my God. Tom Shrek's dad.
And then I get about six text messages from my friends saying, hey, we're hanging out with your dad at a bar.
But growing up, my dad made me and my sister listen to some of the weirdest music, which today is not weird, but he would turn on the Beatles for us in the car and then immediately switch to the rapper DMX. My dad had called me to come open a show for Frankie Ballard downtown at Second Avenue Live. So we packed up and loaded in the back of my truck and parked in the back of Second Avenue Live and got a parking ticket as we were loading in. That's how unlegit we were.
Well, I smoke and I fish, but not near enough to satisfy an itch.
This guy, his name's Ben Vaughn, who is my publisher now at EMI Music Publishing. After the show, he came up and said, hey man, he said, I think you got something here. He said, have you ever written a song before? And I was like, I mean, you know, just stupid songs messing around like in middle school and high school, but nothing serious. And he was like, man, I would like to try to sign you to a very, you know, premature kind of publishing deal just to see if you can write a song. And I was like, well, does it pay more than the laying hardwood floors?
So maybe I could stick them in your pockets, run them through your hair, and we can get rocking.
I guess 6 or 7 months into the deal, my publisher, Ben Vaughn, decided to start taking me around shopping, you know, record deals, so they call it. When I first sat down with Scott Borchetta in his conference room, I played him 3 songs, and he said, man, I'd like to make records with you.
So maybe I could stick them in your pockets, run them through.
My music comes from all my different influences, from country and from rock and roll and the hip hop. My vibe is very different, I think. You know, but it seems to go over well with the people. I want to leave a mark of, you know, that I care a lot, you know, and that I'm a hard worker. I don't ever want to get out on stage and act like I don't want to be there. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, those people are paying money to be entertained and watch a show. And those are ultimately the people that are buying your records and who are joining your fan clubs and all that kind of stuff. And when you get out there, I always want to get out there full of energy. You know what I mean? I got to be here for a reason.